हेलो, वेरी गुड मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स एंड वेलकम बैक टू आर वीडियो लेक्चर ऑफ सब्जेक्ट ओसी एंड आई एम वैभव शाह एंड टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द चैप्टर फोर्थ ऑफ सब्जेक्ट ओसी दैट इज ऑर्गेनाइजिंग एंड दिस विल बी आर लेक्चर नंबर सेकेंड। एज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड इन लेक्चर नंबर फर्स्ट अबाउट द ब्लू प्रिंट विच इज गिवन बाय अ बोर्ड दैट इज बोर्ड ब्लू प्रिंट एंड वॉट विल यू लर्न इन दिस चैप्टर introductory part and meaning. So in today's lecture we are going to discuss or we are going to start a discussion from the definitions of this particular topic that is organizing. In last lecture we discussed that in any of the organization when more than two persons that is when more than one person are working towards the achievement of a common goal, the effective organization is essential. As we all know that management is required when more than one person is engaging in any of the business activities, or we can say when they are engaged in achieving the predetermined objectives of the business. So when more than one person are working towards the achievement of a common goal, the effective organization is essential, and the success and goal achievement of any work is depend upon the proper division of work, distribution of authority and responsibility, and delegation of authority among the employees. In the same format, now let us start with the definition. So first definition which is given over here is the definition of Chester I. Bernard. So, as per Chester I. Bernard, the activity conducted by the cooperation of two or more people and their coordination is called organizing. So, it is the very basic function of management that in planning, we are making a plan for the different activities or for the whole organization. While in organizing, the activity conducted, it means here all the activities are taken place as per the plan. It means in planning we are deciding different activities and their departments and the number of persons who required to carry out that particular activities, etc. But here we are deciding the format of authority and responsibility, division of work and delegation of authority to that particular persons according to their job designation. So here the activity conducted by the cooperation of two or more people. In any of the organization there are different departments are working independently for their own achievement of objectives. But finally the achievement of objective is related with the organization itself. So it means if the production management, finance management, marketing management or human resource management, or we can say the departments of this particular different functional areas working independently, but their final achievement or we can say their final goal is to provide a better goods and services to the customers and satisfying the customer is the main goal of that particular activity. So all these activities conducted by the cooperation of two or more people, because here it is in organizing, or we can say as we discussed in last lecture, one of the example that when there are 100 employees who are working for a common objective, then there should be a proper authority and distribution, authority and responsibility distribution is necessary. So when they are working in a cooperation of two or more people and their coordination is called organizing. So here it is focused that they have to work in a proper manner so that their goal achievement becomes easy and they can easily work towards the achievement of the objectives. Here, whether they are working independently or working with each other or in the cooperation of other, their main goal is the goal of the organization and achievement of that particular goal is necessary of this implementation activity. Now let us discuss the second definition, which is given over here. As per Louis Allen, organizing is the process of identifying and classifying the work to be performed, defining and delegating responsibility and authority, and establishing relationships for the purpose of enabling people to work most effectively together in accomplishing objective. So here, as per this definition, or we can say, Louis Allen has included or covered many of the topics and points which is not covered by the Chester I. Barnard. But for the examination point of view, we have to learn both of this definition, because sometimes it may happens that in the examination they are asking with a particular name of the author that give the definition of Louis Allen or give the definition of Chester I. Barnard. So you have to remember all these definitions. As you all know that you have to prepare three different fair books for the particular subject OC. Here in first book you have to write all the worksheets provided by us. In second book, that is the points book, in which you have to write down all the points that will be helpful in grabbing the 5 marks and 3 marks answers. But along with that point book, you have to mention all the definitions which are covered under the particular chapters. On an average, each and every chapter consisting of different 7 to 8 definitions. It is average. So it may be possible that in any of the chapters there are more than 8 or 10 definitions, while in other chapters there are only 2 or 3 definitions. But examination point of view, all these definitions are very much important and you have to write down in your points book. If there is a possibility that the common questions are there between the worksheet book and the points book, then also you have to write down it twice and do not skip any of the question, because you never knows which question will be compulsory in your examinations. So here, in this particular chapter also, you have to write down and remember both of these definitions, that is the definition of Chester I. Barnard and the definition of Louis Allen. Now let us discuss the definition of Louis Allen. According to his point of view, organizing is the process of identifying and classifying the work to be performed. In planning, we are making a plan for whole organization and not for the different activities, in which the overall objective of the organization is stated very clearly and not of the particular unit. Now let us take the example of manufacturing, because we are having different examples like manufacturing unit, service units and trading, that is exchanging of goods and services units. But for the easiness or for the ease of understanding, we are going to discuss about the manufacturing unit. So first of all, we are here discussing about the identifying and classifying the work. So in any of the manufacturing unit, there are different kind of activities are associated. Like if you are starting, then first of all there will be a purchase department who will purchase all the raw materials, tools and equipments for the organization. There is human resource department who fulfills all the needs of the labor and other workers and employees. There is a finance department who is take care of all the financial matters, that is acquisition of capital, distribution of capital, return on investment and everything. There is a marketing management who is take care about the purchasing, selling, promotional tools, advertising, personal selling, distribution of goods and everything. As we all know that there are 4 P's associated with marketing, that is product. So product development is a part of the marketing, price decision, place from where to sell and the distribution is coming under the purview of marketing. So first of all, in the organizing, we are identifying the activities. So here we are having differently five activities, that is production activity, human resource activity, marketing activity, finance activity, and research and development activity. In research and development, we are developing new product or modifying the existing product according to needs of the customer. There are some other areas are also there, like logistics management, which is taking care of all the inbound and outbound logistics, or we can say the stock maintaining and everything. So first of all, in process of identifying, we are having differently five work, as we have discussed. Now classifying the work. So now in each and every particular activity, we are having sub activities in it. Like in marketing management, first one is the purchase department is there, sales department is there, advertising department is there, promotional department is there, then sales force department, where all the salesmen are working and everything. Likewise, in production also, we are having the raw material maintenance and storage, then production process in which different tools and equipments will be used. They are mentioning over here also. Then the proper maintenance of stock, their product planning, production planning, that is how much of the capacity will be utilized. Each and everything, that is small things. If we are talking about the human resource, then recruitment, selection, promotion, training, development, transfer, and there are so many activities which are associated with it. So in organizing, first of all, we are identifying the different activities, which are these five activities as we have discussed, and classifying the work to be performed. So now we are allotting the work to particular department and not to the person. Like in marketing department, if there is five activities are there, then the work related to that five activities is associated or allotted to that particular department. Now, after identifying and classifying the work, the next step is defining and delegating responsibility and authority. Now, according to the levels of management, that is top level, middle level, and bottom level, we are defining responsibility and authority. It means the highest authority, or we can say the supreme authority, is the top level management. So there is 100% authority and responsibility lies to this board of directors, general manager, CEO, MD, etc. While it comes to the middle level management, it is defining responsibility according to their particular department or particular work area only. Like marketing manager is associated with his particular department only. Finance manager is related with his particular work only. So this is the defining the responsibility and authority. Now, according to the need of that particular department, we are delegating the responsibility and authority. So in any of the department, the main head is the manager. Like in marketing department, marketing manager is the main head. In production department, production manager is the main head. And all others employees who are working under him is the members of the organization. And their responsibility is higher, but their authority will be lower. Because in that particular department, the highest authority will be given to the departmental manager itself. So, after identifying and classifying the work to be performed, here we have divided the work into different departments. Then next, we are defining and delegating responsibility and authority according to their position. Then, next one is establishing relationship for the purpose of enabling people to work most effectively together in accomplishing objective. In any of the organization, there are some kind of disputes are always there regarding the power and authority. Once if we have clearly mentioned all the things in a proper manner, then also there is a least percent chance that there will be the dispute between different departmental heads because of this authority and responsibility. So now we have to establishing a relationship. This relationship will be based on their position and post. Like it, there will be the relation between superior and subordinate. There will be the relationship between peers or colleagues who are working together. So here we are establishing a relationship, that is who will reporting to whom, who will take the charge, who will give instruction, who will give direction and everything. And according to that, we are establishing a relation of superior and subordinates. For the purpose, this establishment of relationship is for the purpose of enabling people to work most effectively together. Because whenever you are working together, there is some kind of disputes and conflicts are always there. But once the relationship amongst them is clearly defined, then there is a least percent chance that dispute will arise. So they have to work together in accomplishing objective, and that's why here in the last position we have to establish the relationship amongst them. So the definition of Louis Allen is divided into three parts. First one is the process of identifying and classifying the work to be performed. Second one is the defining and delegating the responsibility and authority. And third one is the establishing relationship for the purpose of accomplishment of objectives where they are working together. So here we are completing this point, particular point, that is definitions of organizing. Now let us move towards the concept of organizing. It is inevitable to have efficient organization for effective administration and management process. Most of problems of management arises due to ineffective organization in the management. Hence, the business unit could not achieve its goal in the specific time. If the business unit has capable and effective organizing, then through optimum use of resources, time, energy and money can be saved. The problems in the activities of business can be avoided. Now let us discuss the concept. I don't think that after detailed introductory and definition part, we required anything more or anything else or more information for discussing the concept. Because now all of you are very well aware with the concept of this organizing. Then also let us discuss the concept in a very detailed manner. It is inevitable to have efficient organization for effective administration and management process. I have seen so many organizations which are working in a loss, or we can say not efficiently, because of their lack of this proper organizing activities. Sometimes it may happens that with the availability of full-fledged materials and equipments and infrastructural facilities, they are not able to achieve their goals very effectively because of inefficient organizing process. Because it is the main crux of the organization itself. If planning is proper and implementation is not proper, then also the organization will suffer. And contrary, if planning is not proper and implementation is proper, then also the organization will be suffering from a loss. So in both the cases, the planning and organizing should be proper. So for any of the organization to have efficient, it is inevitable that the effective administration and management process should be there. Most of problems of management arises due to ineffective organization in the management. Because at one hand, you are having a proper and efficient resources available. That is, efficient manpower is there, proper raw material is there, tools, equipment, plant, machinery, everything is in the place. But if you are not able to manage them, or if you are not able to properly allocate the different resources according to the need, then you will never succeed. So most of problems of management, whether it is the problem of discipline or the achievement of objective or the achieving of targets or whatever, these problems are arises due to ineffective organization in the management. Because when once proper organizing is there, each and every activity will run smoothly by their own, and there is no need of any kind of supervision and control over them. Hence, the business unit could not achieve its goal in the specific time. It means if proper and effective administration and management process is not there, and there are heavy inefficiencies in the organization, then the business unit could not achieve its goal in the specific time. Sometimes it may happen that it will take more time to complete the particular task, or the task is not completed within a stipulated time period. If the business unit has capable and effective organizing, it is totally contrary to the inefficient management and organizing. That if the business unit has capable and effective organizing, then through optimum use of resources, time, energy and money can be saved, and the problem in the activities of business can be avoided. Likewise, as we are seeing in our schools also, that there is a proper management and administration is there. Each and every activity is properly managed, in a properly manner. Different persons or employees are assigned a different kind of task so that they can work very efficiently. So if the business unit, so same thing is applied to the business unit also, that if the business unit has capable and effective organizing, it means that is proper management is there, and they can fight with any of the challenges or any of the circumstances. Then through optimum use of resources, if efficient management is there, then we can get the maximum benefit of the available resources. Time, everything will be done in a timely manner, or we can save the time, we can save the energy also, because the energy are in a proper way, or we can say each and every activity is done in an efficient manner, and money can be saved because the wastage of resources will be reduced. Each and everything is in a proper manner, and each and every activities are done within a stipulated time period. That's why we can save the money, and problems in the activities of businesses can be avoided. It means the different problems which we are facing while we are doing any kind of activities can be avoided with the help of proper organizing. Now let us move towards the last paragraph of today's lecture. That is, organizing is the concept basically involved with a group of people where two or more people work together. The structure for the work accomplishment in an effective manner is called organizing. Hence, it is also known as arrangement. In an organization, authority and responsibility are delegated to group of people gathered to achieve a common objective, and interrelationship is established among them. For this, the human body is an excellent example. The functions of the different parts of a human body is different, but still all the parts of human body is coordinated to one another. So basically this whole paragraph is associated, or we can say it is the detail of the definition of Louis Allen itself, because here it is clearly mentioned that organizing is the concept basically involved with a group of people where two or more people work together. It means if there is more than one person is associated in any of the particular task, or we can say where two or more people work together, the structure for the work accomplishment in an effective manner is called organizing. Line this statement also, from where two or more people to the organizing. It is also one of the meaning of this particular word, that is organizing. So it is basically involved with a group of people, as the whole management is associated with the group of people, that when more than one person is engaged in any of the activities, then we require a management. So same way, organizing is also the process where two or more people work together, and for the accomplishment of an objective in an efficient manner. Because if we cannot structurize all these activities, or we cannot formatted all these activities, then there will be the chance that some of the activities will be left unused, or we can say incomplete, or some of the activities will be in a duplicate manner, because more than one person will associate it. If there is no proper guidance and no proper authority and responsibility is there. So if more people work together, the structure, it is the basic format for the work accomplishment in an effective manner. It is each and every person is associated with some particular task, and it is the target based where they have to accomplish their objectives. Next, hence it is also known as arrangement. So organizing is in its sense also known as the arrangement of different activities. In an organization, authority and responsibility are delegated to group of people gathered to achieve a common objective, and interrelationship is established among them. Here we can say this concept is basically comes from the definition of Chester I. Bernard and the definition of Louis Allen both. Because in any of the organization, authority and responsibility are the two main element which can be delegated to group of people. So here, first of all, we have to make a proper list of the activities, then classifying the activities according to the needs or according to the departments, and then we have to delegate the authority and responsibility among this group of people who are gathered to achieve a common objective. These objectives might be a production process or accomplishment of some project or some activities or some task. Next, the interrelationship is established among them, which we have discussed in a detailed manner in the definition of Louis Allen, that the interrelationship among these persons, like who is the superior, who is the subordinate, what will be the relationship between peers and colleagues and etc., will be done in a proper manner so that effective organizing is there. And for this arrangement or organizing, the human body is an excellent example, because our body is also the one of the best example of organizing. So the function of the different parts of the human body is different. It means our different parts are working differently. Like the activity of hand is different from the activity of leg. Ear is useful for listening. Nose is useful for smelling. Eyes for watching and seeing and everything. And the main function is of the brain that commands each and every body part to work. So there is also some of the authorities who are commanding or giving orders to the different parts of the body. So here the different parts of a human body is different. Their functions are different, but still all the parts of human body is coordinated to one another. It means they are working in a proper manner so that we can accomplish any of our objective. Our different body parts are working differently, or their functions are different, but in a coordinated manner, it makes the whole human body. Same way, the different activities or functions of the organization is also different. But in a coordinated manner, they all are working for the accomplishment of particular objective of the human body. So with this, we are concluding our session over here. In today's session, we have clearly discussed the definition of Chester I. Bernard and Louis Enel in a very detailed manner. Then we have discussed about the concept of organizing And from next lecture onwards, we are going to discuss about the characteristics of organizing, which are 9 in a number. And after, I think after discussing these characteristics, we will be able to understand the organizing in a very detailed manner. Thank you very much, class, for listening me. Have a happy day.